guys, this is Tanu and welcome back to my channel. So today I'm here with another fitness video, and if you have noticed, then you know that every Wednesday I come back with a fitness related video, and Saturday is all about fashion and style. Okay guys, back into the topic. Today is our leg day, but one more thing I want to say that actually I have tried to make a complete dumbbell workout series. In this series, my first video is all about full body dumbbell workout. Then the second one is upper body dumbbell workout. The third one is all about your midsection, which means core and abs. And today I'm going to show you some lower body dumbbell workouts, which will target your all leg muscles and booty. I have a strong request to all of you, just don't make dumbbell an issue. Because I have already shared those tips and tricks that how you can recreate your dumbbell alternatives just by using your household things. I would strongly recommend you to add weights in your training program, because weights are something those help you to burn your fats and calories, to get more shredded, to build more muscle mass and strength more faster than anything. If you are still not comfortable with weights, then it's totally okay. You just follow my workouts, and whatever I'm doing with dumbbells, you just do it in empty hands. But don't just sit over there, get yourself up, push yourself, get ready and start working out from today guys. Just do it every single day, however you like it to do, and I'm always here to help you out. So if you have any kind of recommendations, suggestions or queries, then please let me know in the comment section below. And very frankly speaking, that I'll be more happier than you to get a chance to help you out. So if you have one, please let me know. Definitely I'll make a video on it. As I have already shared before, that why you should never skip your leg days. So without delaying further, let's get started. Stand with your feet shoulder width apart, toes pointed out 10 to 30 degrees. Hoist a pair of dumbbells up to your shoulder, resting one of the dumbbell heads on the meat of each shoulder. Keeping your body as upright and your upper arms parallel to the floor, brace your abs and lower your body until the crease of the hip drops below the level of the knees by pushing your hips back and bending your knees. Pause at the bottom and then drive your heels into the floor to return back to the starting position. Grab a pair of dumbbells with a neutral grip so that your palms are facing each other. Stand tall with your feet shoulder width apart and arms fully extended at your sides. Push your chest out and take a large step forward with one leg, lowering your rear knee towards the ground while keeping your front shin as vertical as possible. Use the front leg to push yourself back to the starting position. Stand with feet shoulder width apart, a little wider if you prefer, with a set of dumbbells in front of you. Rotate your feet away from the midline of your body so they are turned out 30 to 45 degrees. Bend at the hips, keeping your chest up and driving your hips back as you reach your hands down to grab the dumbbells with an overhand grip. Take a deep breath and engage your core. Keep your spine straight as you squeeze your glutes
Thrust your hips forward and raise the dumbbells as you straighten your legs to stand. Slowly lower the weights back to the floor. That's one rep. Begin standing with your feet hip-width apart and parallel. Hold a dumbbell in your hands down in front of you. Lean forward in your hips, shifting your weight onto one leg while your other leg engages and starts to extend straight behind you. Lift your extended leg and pitch your body forward until your body forms a T-shape. Your arms should be hanging straight down, holding onto the weight. Keep a slight bend in your standing leg. Slowly bring in your extended leg and return to starting position. Repeat with the other leg. Assume a standing position with your feet shoulder width apart and hold the dumbbells with your palms facing inward. Engage your core, bring your shoulder blades together and keep your chest held high. With a slight bend in your knees, hinge at the waist with a straight back and lower the weights towards the ground. You should feel a deep stretch in your hamstrings as your hips move backwards. Inhale. Now reverse the motion as you return to the standing position and squeeze your glutes. Exhale. Maintain tightness in your core and repeat. Named for the way in which you hold the weight in front of your chest with your hands cupped, the goblet squat may in fact be the only squat you need in your workout. Start with a light dumbbell between 25 and 50 lbs and hold it vertically by one hand. Hug it tight against your chest. With your elbows pointing down, lower your body into a squat. Allow your elbows to brush past the insides of your knees as you descend. It's okay to push your knees out. Return to a standing position. Your upper body should hardly move if you are using your legs, hips, and lower back as a unit. Stand with the feet hip distance apart. Hold the dumbbell in each hand by your sides with straight arms. Push your butt back as you bend the knees, squatting down just enough to tap the front end of the dumbbell to the floor. Keep your back straight, not curved or arched. Your chest should be parallel with the floor. Straighten your legs to stand up. This completes one rep. Lie on the floor with your back flat and your heels as close to your body as possible. At the top of the movement, extend your hips forward to get the hip hyperextension. Do some stretching before doing the barbell or dumbbell glute bridge. The bar or dumbbells to lie 2 to 3 inches down from your hips. Hold the bar or dumbbells shoulder width and push it into your thigh where the bar or dumbbells will stay during the entire movement. If during the exercise the bar hurts you, you can use a pad. Explode up and have a controlled movement on the way down. With a dumbbell in each hand, rest the ball of each foot on a wet plate. Keep your torso upright and rest your heels firmly on the floor. Press the balls of your feet into the wet plate and rise up on your toes as high as possible. Pause, then lower back to starting position. Squeeze your calves at the top of the movement. Lower back to the starting position slowly to feel a full stretch in your calves. Don't bend your knees to provide momentum as you rise onto your toes.
Hope you guys found this video helpful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Also share with your friends and family. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel, guys. Keep coming back to my channel. I'll see you in my next video. Till then, take care.